secrets. If you really look at yourself, you will be speechless. What happened to being doctors and teachers? What happened to being your brother's keeper? Nowadays, kids more worried.
Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to my Ironman low level Barrows guide. Beginner information, as you can see, Barrows is located just south of Canifis past the Mortmire Swamp. So these are the Barrows brothers: Ahrim the Blighted, Dharok the Wretched, Torag the Corrupted, Karil the Tainted, Guthan the Infested, Verac the Defiled, and Akrasay the Doomed. We won't be following Akrasay as I don't believe he is necessary for a low level guide, as most low levels won't be able to kill him yet. The first Barrows brother is Ahrim. He has a total level of 150, total life points of 12,000, uses magic and is weak to arrows. His special attack reduces your attack, strength and defense levels. Dharok is a combat level 150 with 12,000 life points, he uses melee and is weak to fire spells. His special attack is when he is on low health, he hits higher. He can hit between 3,000 to 4,000 when on low health, so it's advised to stay away from him when he's on low health. Torag is considered the weakest of the Barrows brothers. He has a total combat level of 150 with 12,000 life points. He uses melee and is weak to water spells. His special ability drains your adrenaline by about 10%, which isn't really too much of a problem, it's just a bit of a pain if you don't have high adrenaline. Karil is, in my opinion, one of the harder bosses to kill of the Barrows brothers. He has a total combat level of 150. He has 12,000 life points, he uses range and is weak to stab. He has a special ability which drains your magic levels, so it is advised to protect from him and try and kill him as quickly as possible. The next Barrows brother is Guthan. He has a combat level of 150 and 12,000 life points also. His attack style is melee and he is weak to air spells. His special ability is that he heals off you from a 1-to-1 ratio on certain occasions. So basically, if he were to hit 500 on you, he would heal 500 HP. The final brother is Verac. He has a combat level of 150 and 12,000 life points as well. His attack style is melee and he is weak to earth spells. His special ability allows him to ignore armor stats when attacking on certain occasions, which means that occasionally he's going to hit a lot higher than other times. Here you can see a map of which mound has which brother in it. It's advised to go from Ahrim to Karil, then Torag, Verac, Dharok and Guthan, but I'm going to explain that in the next part of the guide. I'd recommend taking around about 4 prayer pots as well as the best food you can get. Also take a shield so you can heal up with that, and take runes for an ice spell, which is one of the desert treasure spells. The armor and weapons I'd use is magic armor and weapons, the best you can get, as well as having a ring of life in case you get hit down too much. So guys, this is just me showing you how I'm getting there. Now, I use a shortcut in this method I didn't mean to. I'd unlocked it and there was no way I could have not done it. So basically, when I go in here, as you can see, I got teleported straight to the end here. Basically, you want to run south of just straight through Mortmire Swamp and then round this little windy area here through the town to the east, which is Morton, I believe, and then straight across and you'll be right there at the Barrows location. Also to note, when going through Mortmire Swamp, the ghasts can rot your food, which means that, you know, you might want to take druidic pouches if you feel it necessary. This is the order in which I'd kill them. I'd start with Ahrim to build up some adrenaline. He doesn't hit too much, so it's always good to start on him. Then go to Karil with adrenaline, protect against him because he hits the most and you can just use all your thresholds on him. Then it doesn't really matter from then on. I've just put those in for reference, but it doesn't matter from then on which brothers you go to. I just recommend starting with Ahrim and then going to Karil. These are the solutions to the puzzle doors below the crypts in the tunnels, and I'd recommend memorizing these answers because they're going to need to be answered really, really quickly. Otherwise, the puzzle's going to disappear and you're going to be a bit stuffed. This is the one I'd recommend checking out the most. It's the hardest one to get, and I always skip that one. You can also, when you're in the rooms, just skip past one. If you see one that you don't know the answer to, if you click away and go back on it, it'll reset the puzzle. Also, it's worth noting that if you do get a puzzle wrong, the doors will switch around and you'll have to run around to find the new door to go through. Okay guys, so this is an example trip of me going on a trip at Barrows. I think this trip went really well bar the loot, which you'll see at the end. So basically I started off with Ahrim here. He took me down a bit with some stats, but of course I wasn't using melee, so it wasn't really a problem. So I took him out and built up my adrenaline. And once you've got adrenaline, if you want to save it for one of the other brothers while crossing over to a different mound, if you use either anticipate or freedom, as you can see at the top left, that I just used then, it sort of sticks at your adrenaline. It doesn't drain it. It allows it to stay there a bit longer. So here I just bashed out with thresholds on Karil to kill him as quickly as possible because he tends to hit the most. I also protected against him. He is the only one of the brothers I protect against because I managed to freeze the others, stopping them from being able to attack me too much. So here I'm killing Torag. He's considered the easiest one, and as you can see, I've had no real problems killing him. He was quite easy. He's weak to water spells, so the ice spells worked really well against him. This here is a bit of a harder one because Verac here is a lot stronger to the attacks we use than the others. It's kind of a pain, but as you can see, every 5 spell attacks I do, I run to a different location because that's when they're going to be unfrozen. They last for about 10 seconds when frozen, which is around about 5 hits, so I run away. Here I got hit quite a lot, which was a little bit unfortunate, but still. Here I use the rejuvenation, I believe it's called. It's an ultimate ability which restores you for 40% of your life points, which is really useful. You need a shield to use it, which is why I bring one along with me. Here is Dharok. Now, he is the one that I definitely recommend staying away from, if at all possible, because he can hit a lot. I have known people to have just been absolutely one hit on hardcore Ironmen by him because of his ability. So I used Asphyxiate to stop him in his tracks so he couldn't get me at the end of that kill. The final one is Guthan here, and here you'll get a message saying that you've got to go into the tunnels to find him. So what you want to do is just find a door which leads to a chest room. You can see the chest in the center of the little maze you're in, and basically you got to find the door that leads onto that. So I found it in a second right here. So you answer the puzzle, which I got right, and you go through the door. Now in the tunnels, it's worth noting that you can bump into the brother you've got to fight just around in the tunnels. You don't have to open the chest. As you can see, I bumped into Guthan here without opening the chest. So I trapped him behind this safe spot here behind that torch, and then opened the chest and claimed my loot. Also, be wary that your loot can end up dropping on the floor. So these are the rewards. You can get Barrows equipment, which is the Barrows weapons and the Barrows army. You can get a load of coins, a load of blood runes, chaos runes, death runes, and mind runes. Also, you can get yourself some Bolt Rack, which is used in Karil's crossbow, Barrow Stones, which are used for the Rise of the Six minigame, Dragon Helms, and Crystal Triskelion Fragments, which are also very, very useful. These are just the notable drops. There are other drops, but they aren't quite as good. So guys, that's it for this video. Hopefully you found this useful. If you did, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any more videos. Also, make sure you check out the other guides and all that stuff. Leave a like rating and a comment, all that good stuff. Anyway guys, thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.